Hello, my name is Nelly. I'm from Georgia. I'm a master's student at Jejian University, and today I'm honored to interview Dr. Hyung-Jong Lee. Can you briefly introduce your research to us?
Thank you. So I work on development of new type of microscopy imaging technique that will help us visualize molecular machinery of a cell. So this is important because the fundamental unit of all the organisms is a cell. And cells are composed of different biomolecules like protein, lipid, carbohydrates, and nucleic acids. But it is very challenging to directly visualize these small molecules in individual cells. But our technique can do this because the chemical bonds inside these biomolecules are vibrating constantly at different frequencies. So this is like their signature or like a fingerprint. And measuring these energies, we can determine the identity of the molecules. And we further developed the strategies to make this spectroscopy imaging much faster with high sensitivity, so that we'll be able to capture these small molecules at different locations inside the cell. So this basically, this technology tackles challenges in life science field for this label-free functional imaging with subcellular resolution. Now we can using this technology to understand how cells live and communicate at the molecular level. And eventually, this is important for curing cancer and neural diseases.
What do you think are most important traits as innovators?
I believe the most important trait of innovators is not afraid of doing new things. Innovation requires creativity and combination of different disciplines. So that means you will need to learn new things and get into new fields and get out of your comfort zone constantly to implement these new ideas into action. So I remember how hard it was when I first started working on neuroscience field in combination with our new imaging technique. It was third year of my graduate school, and we had this idea of developing a new optical imaging technique for neuroimaging that will eventually be a groundbreaking technique for how we measure neural activities. But it is not an easy task because it requires a very deep understanding of a technique called electrophysiology. And this technique is known to be very difficult as well. And being in the optics lab, obviously we don't have this type of expertise as well. So what I did was I actively seek help from our collaborators, learning all the way from how to culture neurons, how to set up this patch clamp device, how to do the experiments, analyze data, and even the fundamentals behind this technique and the neuroscience field. We had multiple difficulties, but eventually I came up with an approach that is only possible if you have enough understanding in both optical engineering part and also the neuroscience part. And that became the breakthrough of this project. And we successfully achieved the most sensitive label-free voltage imaging record. And so far, this record is not achievable by other label-free voltage imaging technique.
As a female scientist working in a male-dominant area, what difficulties you have faced along the way?
So indeed, it is a male-dominant arena, and I often find myself the only female in the room. I guess the most difficult part as a female scientist, I'm actually experiencing it right now, is having a baby. So I gave birth to my daughter in April. Because of this event, the research progress has been slowed down a little bit because you know, being pregnant, you have so many restrictions. There are certain experiments that you cannot do, and the work hour is likely to reduce because you'll feel tired very easily. And at that time, I naively thought that after giving birth, everything will go back to normal. But actually, it is after giving birth that changed my life completely. Because now I have a new role in addition to being a scientist. I'm also a mother. So I know that being a father is also a big change for male scientists. But because of these biological differences between male and female, the efforts and time required by from mother is just a lot. So in order to adapt to this change, I've been trying to plan things ahead and try to use my time more efficiently. And I think the most important part for me to get through this difficulty is one is a great support from my family. My husband is also working in a similar research field, so he knows what I need to go through this difficult time. So he's been helping me a lot and supporting me to get through this period. And another important part is that I really enjoy doing research, and science is something I'm determined to pursue.
What advice do you have for girls who is inspired to push an academic career?
So advice that I would like to give to girls who want to pursue this academic career is that make sure this path is something you really believe in and devote yourself completely. And at the same time, put efforts to make a team because you're not alone. Many things require teamwork to accomplish.
You were born in South Korea, then working in the United States. So what you drove to China to Zhejiang University?
But the easy answer is family. My husband is Chinese, and now we are both tenure-track professors at Zhejiang University. But actually, we came up with this decision together after serious considerations. After finishing PhD training and the postdoc training in the United States, we had multiple offers from all around the world. So we visited multiple institutes. That's when I first had a chance to visit Zhejiang U. And I found Zhejiang University is one of the few universities that includes so many different disciplines. Especially the ones that are deeply connected to my research area, like biomedical engineering, optical engineering, life science, medicine, physics, etc. So I felt very confident that I will be able to continue to have a long-term development in my research career here. And I also found Zhejiang University is very open-minded. Unlike some of the places where people are very conservative, Zhejiang U will listen to PIs, needs from the PIs and researchers regarding their career development and also research projects and try to make changes, becoming the pioneers. And actually, Hangzhou City is similar in that way too. There are many, this city has many advanced thinking and a lot of emphasis on promoting development of new technologies. I was also driven by our department, College of Biomedical Engineering and Instrument Science. I learned that this is one of the first places for this biomedical engineering field got started in China. So overall, this place has so much history, but it's not afraid to reform. That's what I really like about Zhejiang University.